O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare praise. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for you, my sheep. Sheep need a shepherd, but not any shepherd will do. We need the good shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. We are the sheep of the Lord's pasture. We are the church. But the one thing with sheep, they love to wander. They love to be distracted by other things. As Isaiah says, we all like sheep have gone astray. Each has turned to his own ways. Sheep without a shepherd are in heap big trouble. They find all kinds of danger, the danger that's on every side. And the reason why sheep wander, there must be something better over there. Curiosity, boredom, looking for excitement, seeking a thrill, and the green pastures always look greener on the other side of the road. And sheep wander. They wander in this fallen world. And when they get to the other side, all that they find is a barren wasteland. A place full of death. Because that's all you'll find. Living outside of the good shepherd, there's only death. Sin and death abound. The wolves are growling. The lions are prowling. And the serpents are slithering. It's the nature of living in a fallen world. A world full of sin and death. Sheep need a shepherd. And today is full of danger. Confirmation Day. It's full of danger because of the wandering sheep. Because of the distractions. Because of the allure of the world. Because of sin. So whether you're being confirmed today, or whether you're confirmed 50 years ago, the same sin persists and lives inside every one of us. Sheep that wander. Or to use today and to say, I'm all finished. I'm all done. It's kind of like graduation. When you graduate from school, you never have to go back. Many of the outward adornments of confirmation look the same. The robes, the flowers, the family, the friends, the pictures, the luncheons, the celebrations, and the congratulations. That a boy. Treating confirmation like graduation leads to wandering sheep. It's not what today's about. You never graduate from church. You're never done. You're never finished. Because when you graduate from school, you can throw those papers away. You never have to go back to school, unless you want to, for a 20 or 30 year reunion. And when you go back, it's simply a walk down memory lane. It's sentimental. But that's not church. Church is a place in which we are tended to. We need the good shepherd. The good shepherd tending his flock. The problem is not confirmation. The problem is our sin and wandering sheep. Ears that close, hearts that become hard, and we stop listening. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? We stop listening to the voice of the good shepherd. And we've seen it all too often. Those who've fallen away. Judas, Cain, Israel, and some of the members of our own family. And we've seen the heartbreak. We've seen the pain of those who've left the church. Sheep that wander. So God's word gives us warning. Be alert. Be sober-minded. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, seeking someone to devour. Resist him. Stand firm in the faith. Satan's goal is to separate you from the flock. Satan's goal is to separate you from the good shepherd. And sheep that are separated are easy pickings. They're easy prey for Satan to devour. So Satan hates today. He hates today that you confess Jesus as Lord. He aches today that you're believing with your hearts. And so he wants to tempt you. He wants to tempt you with apathy. Indifference. I'm okay. Everything's fine. And he wants to tell you, your sin's no big deal. Everybody does it. Well, that's not the voice of the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd comes to tend his flock. And the Good Shepherd even brings back the wayward. Ezekiel 33. I seek out my sheep. I will rescue them. I will feed them on good pasture. I myself will be the shepherd to the sheep. I will seek the lost. I will bring back the strayed. I'll bind up the injured. And I'll strengthen the weak. You know his voice. You know the voice of the Good Shepherd. And the pitch and the tone of the voice of the Good Shepherd tells you the truth. He doesn't tell you what you want to hear. He tells you what you need to hear. And he tells you the truth. And he tells you the truth about your hearts. What is going on with our hearts? You shall have no other gods. You shall fear, love, and trust in God above all things. Those who wander, those who go away, they follow their hearts. And the Lord teaches us the only thing that's in our heart is sin. And that sin abounds. Matthew 15. It's out of the heart that come evil thoughts. Murder, adultery, sexual immorality, theft, false witness, and slander. So the voice of the Good Shepherd calls you to repent of your sin. To repent of your sin and to live in forgiveness. Because the life of a Christian is one of repentance. And the Lord creates in you a new heart, a clean heart, a heart that follows, a heart that believes. And your hearts have a purpose. And the purpose of your heart is to believe in Jesus and to trust in him with everything you have. He leads you. The voice of the Good Shepherd teaches you about your bodies. Your bodies that were created by the Lord. Your bodies that are the temple of the Holy Spirit. You shall not misuse the name of the Lord your God. In holy baptism, the Lord has put on you his name. And you are now holy. You are the holy and royal priesthood. And you're all clean by virtue of your baptism. So now the Lord teaches you how to use your bodies. 1 Corinthians. The body is not meant for sexual immorality, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. Flee sexual immorality. Do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit? You're not your own. You're bought at a price. So glorify God in your bodies, and let marriage be held in honor by all. So lead a sexually pure and decent life. In how you speak and how you act. Pray that the Lord would give you strength to lead a chaste life. And that one day, he would bring along your side a godly spouse. A godly man or woman to marry. To be together in the faith. The voice of the Good Shepherd teaches you about your ears. Your ears that have a purpose. And the purpose of your ears is to hear the life-giving word of God. Remember the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. Do not despise preaching and his word, but hold it sacred. Gladly hear it and learn it. The Sabbath day has everything to do with your attitude. Not despising, but gladly. Gladly hearing the word, hearing preaching, and believing it. As Jesus says, my sheep hear my voice. They listen and they follow me. I call them own by name, and the sheep will follow me. They'll listen to my voice. The word of God ringing in your ears and reigning in your heart. It's how the Holy Spirit works on you. After all, we take no credit for this day. We take no credit for believing in Jesus. The third article of the Creed, I, by my own reason or strength, cannot believe in Jesus Christ my Lord or come to him. But the Holy Spirit has called you by the gospel enlighten you with his gifts. In the same way, he calls, gathers, and enlightens the whole Christian church on earth and keeps it with Jesus Christ. It's the gospel that Jesus bore your sin, that Jesus died, and it's by his wounds that you're healed. Because we were straying like sheep. But now you've returned. You've come back to the overseer, the shepherd of your souls, Jesus Christ himself. The voice of the good shepherd always tells you the truth. He calls wandering sheep to repentance in order to forgive them. Oh, and the good shepherd, he loves you. He truly does. How do you know? His love was extended for you on the cross. This is his steadfast love that endures forever. When he bore the weight of your sin and the sin of the world, he died in your place. He suffered the wrath of God against all your sin, all your wandering, and he brings you back. Jesus says, I'm the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep, only to take it back up again. I have the authority to lay it down and the authority to take it back up again. So it's at Calvary. Jesus draws the enemies of the church in near. The wolves, the lions, snakes. And he defeats them by his blood. By the blood of Christ, the wolves are sent running. The lions are slain. And the snake is crushed under his bloody heel. Jesus does the work of salvation because the thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. I've come that you may have life and have it to the full, have it eternally. So today you're not done. Today you're not finished. Confirmands, parents, sponsors, body of Christ at Zion, you're not done. You're not done being tended to. You're not done being shepherded to. You're not done receiving. You're not done learning. You're not done believing. Oh, there'll be a day when you're done. And the day that you're done is when the Lord delivers you from evil. When the Lord takes you home to heaven, you'll be all done there. It's all finished there. But until then, you are to hallow his name. You're to hear the word of God taught in its truth and purity. And your lives are to be lived wholly to the Lord, by and according to the word of God. As we hear in Revelation, be faithful unto death, and I'll give you the crown of life. He's given you ears to hear, hearts to believe, and mouths to confess Christ's holy name. And today, he feeds you. He feeds the flock, and he feeds you for the very first time his most holy meal, his body and his blood. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The feeding of the sheep, the tending of the flock, ears to hear, mouths to receive, and hearts to believe. And it's in the Lord's Supper you are confessing the Lord's death until he comes. You're confessing the truth. You're confessing the Lord's real presence serving you here in the supper. As Paul says, as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Today is a great day. It is a grand day of celebration for the church, for you, and the whole body of Christ, having believers, brothers and sisters in Christ, confessing his name before the world. Because sheep need a shepherd. And Jesus, shepherding you, says, fear not. Do not be afraid. I'm the first and I'm the last. I'm the living one. I was dead, and behold, I live forever and ever. I hold in my hands the keys of death and Hades. And I open for you, my sheep, the gate to everlasting life. The things we do on a regular basis shows the importance therein. There are things regularly we do for our bodies to sustain life. What do? We eat and we drink. We feed our bodies. We nourish them. We bathe regularly or semi-regularly. we rest, we take naps, and we sleep at night. And without these things, the body would run out of gas. The body would fail to operate. The things we do regularly show the importance. So the Good Shepherd washes you. In the font, he makes you all clean. He gives you his name. He feeds you with his most holy, precious body and blood to give you strength along the life's journey. And he gives you rest. He gives you rest from your sin by hearing the word preached and by having your sins forgiven. The Good Shepherd loves the sheep. He gives you ears to hear. He gives you mouths to confess and hearts to believe. And he calls you each by name: Alita, Katie, Dimitri, Ashley, Adam, Emma, Mary, and Nicole. And what does he call you to do? Come and follow me. To listen and hear his voice, and following the Good Shepherd, it gives you life and life without end. The prayer today is that you continue to believe. You continue to gather where the Lord serves and takes care of his children. May God grant it to you this day and to life everlasting. In the name of Jesus, amen. Rejoice on the Lord's gifts. Rejoice in his mercy. We, the flock, cannot be silent. We confess his name before the world. And today we use the words of the Nicene Creed, page 158. Please stand for the creed.